So we'll start by wrapping some thread behind the bead. You want to build it up so that way the bead doesn't slide back and get in the way of the other stuff or the back of the foot. Then you just want to build up a little thread body. And then we're going to tie in the tail. I don't use too much pheasant tail. I'd rather work with a little than a lot. So I have about 6 or 7 feathers. Then I tie that in. And you could always adjust them. It's easier to make them shorter than it is longer. So you tie those in and then just adjust them to the size that you want. You can do a couple wraps behind to make them stick up. We get our copper wire. This is small or extra small. It's better to use the smaller stuff and not the stuff that's too heavy. You just want a small rib that secures the pheasant tail down. And it also provides a little bit of shine. And then we just advance our thread up to about a third of the way. Because that's where we're going to start our other section. And then we just wrap the pheasant tail up.
So that's how you get the legs to sit where you want.
About two thirds of the way up. Then we tie that off.
Then when you get to the eyes,
snip that. And then we counter wrap our wire. So I'm wrapping the wire towards me. This helps it make the fly more durable. And we just tie that off, cut the wire. When we tie in our flash, sometimes it's easier to cut it to a point. It makes it easier to tie in, especially on the smaller size. This is only a 14, so it's pretty big. Then we tie that in, and that's what we're gonna pull over. And that's where you get the name Flashback from. Then we take about 3 or 4 strands of peacock herl. And this is gonna be used as the underbody. I use 4 because I like to build it up a little bit.
Thank you.
Then we wrap the peacock. Only about 3 or 4, 5 times. Up to right behind the bead. Secure that down with a few wraps. Cut. Now we are gonna take some more pheasant tail for the legs. Again, you could tie them in long and then make them shorter. Then we're gonna cut some more for the other side. I do the side away from me first, and then the side closest to me. Then adjust them so they're even. Trying to get them close to perfect. And then take some wraps to secure them. Here, next we take the flashback, pull it over, pull it down, and pull it tight. This also helps with the legs. Wrap that, secure that down. And then we could just cut everything at once. This fly I love for fishing it for wild browns and wild rainbows. You know, I do really well with wild browns on this fly, and usually they're bigger browns.